Welcome to Corvette Today, the podcast that talks about everything Corvette, with your host Steve Garrett, MC and DJ at one of the largest Corvette weekends in the country, Corvette Fun Fest, president of the Corvette Club of Kansas City, Missouri, and radio disc jockey at the number one radio station in Kansas City for over 40 years. Here's Steve Garrett.
Thanks for listening to Corvette Today, the podcast that talks about everything Corvette. I'm your host, Steve Garrett. I appreciate you tuning in. You can listen to Corvette Today on all podcast platforms. You can also listen on your smart device. Just say Alexa or Hey Google, play the podcast called Corvette Today, and you're connected. Also, visit the Corvette Today website. It's CorvetteTodayPodcast.com. And while you're there, make sure you visit the Corvette Today merchandise store. You can also sign up for Corvette Today emails, notifications, and updates at corvettetoday.ck.page. And don't forget, join the Corvette Today Facebook group. We have over 3,000 members, and I'd love to have you as a member as well. I'm also excited to tell you about the new YouTube channel for Corvette Today. See your favorite Corvette Today podcasts now on YouTube. First, I'd like to thank our flagship sponsors of Corvette Today, Aerolari Wheels, a true forged wheel with over 20 unique design styles to choose from for your C8 and wide-body versions of the C7, C6, and C5 Corvette. It's an absurd value starting at only $1,988 for a set of four fully forged wheels. And use the promo code CT100 for Corvette Today 100 and get $100 off your purchase. Visit aerolari.com. That's AEROLARRI.com. And use the promo code CT100 for your $100 discount. Also, Corvette Fever magazine. Corvette Fever has been relaunched with an online and printed version. The online version has incredible interactivity with hidden photos and information, and the printed version is nothing like you've ever seen before, huge and glossy. Get your free online version at CorvetteFeverMag.com. You can also sign up for the printed version there as well. Corvette Fever magazine, come along for the ride. Also, MidEngineCorvetteForum.com, the forum that focuses on the new mid-engine C8 Corvette. Meet a lot of fellow Corvette enthusiasts like yourself at MidEngineCorvetteForum.com. Also, a shout-out to CanadianCorvetteForum.com, welcoming Corvette owners from around the world. My guest on Corvette Today is incredibly active in the Corvette community. He's on the board of directors for the Chip Miller Foundation. He's also very active with Toys for Tots. And he was the 2019 national chairman for the 25th anniversary of the National Corvette Museum and all the caravans. He's big on social media, including Facebook and Instagram, and has a growing YouTube channel called Zipity's Garage. He is Jeff Duda. Jeff, welcome to Corvette Today.
Hey, thank you, Steve. I am honored and humbled to be here. This is a dream come true in the car hobby. So thanks for having me.
Buddy, it's good to have you. And thank you for taking the time to do this. Jeff, let's start off. And I always talk about everybody's early years. Let's talk about your early years growing up, where you grew up, your parents' influence, maybe your dad's influence on you as an automotive person as you are now.
Yeah, absolutely. And like you had mentioned, it is some family heritage or legacy, you can say.
Yeah.
My father had a 1962 Honduras maroon Corvette before I was a gleam in his eye. My mom tells the story while they were dating that my mom thought the thing was a piece of junk, but my dad absolutely loved the car. He talks in such passion and fond memories of that vehicle and tells me about some of his late night drives home from the local municipalities that were following him. A little bit of a faster than legal speeds, we can say. And since he was the only one in the area that had a Corvette, the next morning at the gas station or at the local coffee shop, you might get a conversation with a local police officer and say, "Hey, you're getting home a little late last night, weren't you, Gary?" And, you know, Gary would just chuckle it off and on to the next topic, so to speak. So, yes, that's where my passion comes from, is my father had a 62 and he had a 67 Camaro. It was a Rally Sport SS. And as the story goes, he remembers when he picked it up from the dealership, it had two window stickers on it. There were so many options on the car.
Wow.
So you can say I got my enthusiasm for the automobile from my dad.
Very cool. So when did you realize that you were really a car person or a car guy?
I can almost pinpoint it to the date. It was a 1978 L82 dark blue Corvette with a four-speed on the floor, an Oyster interior, and the 8-track player.
Oh.
It was a family friend of ours showed up at our house. The father had just purchased this car with his son, Dave, and his dad said, come on, guys, let's go for a ride. So the four of us climbed into this 1978 Corvette. My father in the front seat, Dave and I kind of huddled in the back. It was a big coupe, so you had all that room in the back. It's just one of those things that's ingrained in my head is the driving in that 1978 with the 4-speed, the motor. And again, one of the things that's ingrained in my head is the band Queen was playing on the 8-track and it was Another One Bites the Dust. So, well, you know, I know you're a music guy. So yes. Whenever I hear that song, that takes me right back into that Corvette. I know exactly when it started. And from there, it was just knew I had to have one day.
That's cool. That's a great story. You know, every Corvette owner has a story, and that's a great one to get you into the hobby. That's for sure.
Yeah, absolutely. And like you said, in most of your podcast, you're saying every Corvette owner has a story behind it, and I'm no different than anybody else in that regard.
Well, Jeff, talk about some of the Corvettes you've owned in the past. I know that you got a great story that just happened last week, as a matter of fact, as well.
Yes, I do. Like you said, I have a fun story to talk about what I did this past weekend, but let's rewind a little bit. My wife, before we had our daughter, she was a car nut as well. So when we first got married, she was driving an Audi TT, loved the sports cars. We both wanted a Corvette. In fact, we were very, very close to purchasing a 1996 Corvette, but just at the time, it wasn't the right thing to do. Fast forward a couple of years till 2001, and we all know what happened on September 11th of that year. Shortly thereafter, my wife had graduated with her master's degree in nursing, has her advanced practice nursing license as a nurse practitioner. So as a graduation gift, I traded in my 4-wheel drive pickup truck on a used 1998 triple black convertible with an automatic transmission, had it parked in the garage with a big red bow on it. And when she came home from work one afternoon, I asked her to open up the garage door. And there it was as a graduation gift for her. She was blown away by it. And she drove that car every day to work for probably about 3-4 months until the winter came. And then right. She's like, we need to find another car to drive back and forth to work for winter. But we still kept the Corvette. And she absolutely loves telling the story that one day driving from work, traffic light to traffic light, this young kid in a import sports car. I remember exactly what it was. It was a Maxima. He would rev the engine right next to her at the red light. He would take off. Car would make a whole bunch of noise. Wouldn't go very fast. Would take a whole bunch of noise and drive away. My wife would just cruise away nice and slow. This happened about 2 or 3 times. Finally, my wife got fed up with it and put her foot into the pedal on the throttle and just toasted the kid in the Maxima. And as the story goes, he wouldn't pull up next to her. He pulled in behind her at the next traffic light. He wouldn't even acknowledge how bad he got beat. She enjoyed that car very, very much. We took that car. Talk about the Corvette Caravans. We were fortunate enough to take that car on the 50th anniversary Caravan. Now, it was the 50th anniversary for the car, and that was in 2003. That Caravan was a little bit unique because it celebrated the milestone anniversary of the vehicle, not necessarily of the National Corvette Museum. So we drove that car from New Jersey to Bowling Green, Kentucky, and I tell you what, I was hard-pressed to put the roof up. We wanted the top down the entire trip. We had an absolute blast. And at the time, we could still do the assembly plant tours of the Corvette assembly plant right across the street from the museum. And when we walked out, what was sitting right there, now remember, this was the summer of 2003, so they had a brand new, yet to be available for sale, 2004 commemorative edition Le Mans Blue Z06 sitting right side out the exit of the assembly plant. And my wife and I just looked at each other. We're like, that's gorgeous. And we fell in love with it. Kind of looked at that car as almost like the 96 Grand Sport in the C4 era. This commemorative edition kind of held the same panache for us in the C5 era. Fast forward about another year or so, maybe 6-8 months, we were selling our house, moving into an apartment. Kind of in between homes, no kids, no mortgage really, because we sold the house and we were moving into an apartment. But we said, let's take a ride down to Cape May. So we jumped in the convertible, drove down to Cape May, went out, had a couple drinks, had a nice dinner. On the way home, stopped and saw some of my friends at a Corvette dealership that's in Atlantic City that at the time was referred to as Kerbeck Corvettes, now the Sioka dealership. And as the story goes, we drove home the 2004 Z06.
That's awesome.
So went out for a nice dinner, and we traded in my wife's graduation gift for a car that she couldn't drive because it was a manual transmission.
Oh, well. All right, now talk about the two Corvettes that you own right now.
Yeah, so I still am the proud owner of that 2004 commemorative edition Z06. Original owner, still have that to this day. In fact, I think I've put every single mile that's on that car myself outside of a service tech driving it. My goal was to find another Corvette that we could use as a daily driver and find one that my wife can take out on trips, whether we're doing parades with our local clubs or whether we're doing the Caravan, and was really looking for an automatic so that she could drive that car. With the advent of the C8, C7s, we're coming up a little bit more on the used market now that everybody's kind of upgrading into the C8. Changes in my work recently, I'm not driving nearly as much as I used to, gave an opportunity to look for a Corvette as a daily driver. Literally in the past 2 weeks, had conversations with my wife about what we were looking to buy and made the comment. I said, I'd really like to get an automatic so that she could drive it. She made the comment. She goes, Jeff, you're going to be the primary driver of it. So get what you want. Get the transmission that you desire. So at that point, really didn't pigeonhole us to one transmission or the other. We wanted a Stingray, didn't necessarily want a Grand Sport for a daily driver or a Z06, wanted the softer suspension, smaller wheels and so forth. But I definitely wanted one that had some nice creature comforts and some higher options. Happened to find one sitting at Criswell Chevrolet, and that's where one Mike Furman happens to work. So contacted Mike. What's really, really great, this buying process with Mike, he and I never spoke on the phone at all about the deal. It was all done electronically over email, back and forth, very professional. Is the car available? Yes, it is. Send me the information, confirmed all the different options, offered a price, went back and forth a little bit, put me in touch with the business manager, worked out the financing. And this past weekend, I took an Uber. Actually, it was a Lyft driver. Drove me from just outside of Philadelphia down to Gaithersburg, Maryland, about a 2.5 hour drive with a Lyft guy. It was cheaper than a one-way rental car, and picked up this 2019 Stingray. It is a 3LT with a Z51 and magnetic ride. Pretty unique color combination in that it's shadow gray with the spice red interior.
Ooh.
So it's a nice looking, at least I think it's a nice looking car. And people say, okay, well, just because it's low production, maybe that means a lot of people didn't like the color combination. But quite frankly, I'm thrilled with it. And after speaking with the Corvette Museum, they confirmed that there were two Stingrays in 2019 made in this color combination with the shadow gray and spice red. And I have one of the two that were produced. So that's pretty cool.
That's fantastic, Jeff. Well, buddy, let's take our first break. And when we come back, we'll, in segment number two, talk more about your Corvette years and your affiliations here on Corvette Today.
Stretch the life of your Corvette's paint with Nova Stretch Performance Protective Covers. Nova Stretch covers provide superior protection for your C5 through C8 Corvette, utilizing stretch fabric technology and an innovative fastening system for quick installation and easy removal and storage. Made in the USA for a tailored fit, the patented design and breathable mesh protects your Corvette without rubbing or chafing the paint like traditional bras. And unlike clear film solutions, Nova Stretch provides full front-end coverage including the grille, keeping radiators and heat exchangers clean without creating airflow issues. Visit NovaStretch.com and use the code CORVETTETODAY15 to get 15% off your order. Protect your Corvette with Nova Stretch. VetFinders.com is the internet's original Corvette classified ads website, with classified ads starting at just $25, and every ad runs until your Corvette is sold. If you're in the market for a Corvette, VetFinders.com has over 500 Corvettes for sale from all around the USA and Canada, and covering all eight generations. Visit VetFinders.com, the internet's destination for buying and selling Corvettes. That's V-E-T-T-E Finders.com.
And now, back to Corvette Today with your host and my husband, Steve Garrett.
Hey, thanks for listening to Corvette Today, the podcast that talks about everything Corvette. I'm your host, Steve Garrett. With me this week is Jeff Duda with Zipity's Garage from the YouTube channel. And we'll talk about Zipity's Garage here in segment number three. But first, Jeff, let's talk about your Corvette affiliations and things like that. Tell everybody what Corvette Club you're affiliated with right now.
Absolutely. Yeah, I'm a proud member of the original Garden State Corvette Club, which is based in southern New Jersey, just outside of Philadelphia. The club has been around since 1970 is when it was founded. So it's one of the oldest clubs in the state of New Jersey. And quite frankly, it's one of the larger ones. And I'm happy to say we're pretty active. We do meetings twice a month.
Wow.
And I've been a member of that club since late 2001. So coming up
20 years.
Exactly. It's just a great bunch of people. Like any civic organization, you have that one binding tie. And this one's obviously the Corvette. But you stick around for the people. And I think that's what the legacy of this club is just the people that are involved with it and all the doors that it has opened to new relationships. Because there's so many different people that I would not have met if it was not for this car. Perfect examples right here speaking with you. I'm a fan because I sit here and listen to what you do with Taj and Harlan and Sharon Brauner from the museum and Lance Miller from the Chip Miller Foundation. Now I'm a part of that fraternity.
Absolutely right, buddy. That's for sure. Talk about some of the big events and some of the charitable events that you guys do.
Sure. We are a registered 501c3 nonprofit organization with the state of New Jersey. So that's one of our biggest designations. We are a lifetime business club member with the National Corvette Museum. So we're proud of that fact. Kind of look at it as the museum is the mothership of all the Corvette clubs out around the country. So we like to make sure that we give back to that mothership, so to speak, with the Corvette Museum. But then locally, we like to get involved with area food banks and not just the large ones in the metropolitan areas, but also some of the little local ones, whether it be ones at a local church, local schools. We get involved with where we can help out families in that regard. We do a lot with a particular veterans home down in Vineland, the Vineland's Memorial Home. In 2020, they actually sent us a letter thanking us for their donations and frankly told us that the only donations they had received all year were from our Corvette Club. So we were sad to hear that, but also proud to hear that, that we were still supporting these folks in a year that was a little bit lean for many. As far as another military charity is the Marines Toys for Tots organization. Our local club has been involved with that on a couple different levels with a couple different organizations, whether it be a Johnson's Farm. It's a local farmers market that does a big toy drive here every November. They invite all car clubs to come out. Anybody in the car hobby, come out for a car cruise at Johnson's Farm. Well, we kind of helped Johnson's get off the ground with their cruise nights when they first started with it. We've got a good relationship with the folks at Johnson's, and we called them one day, probably a week or two before the first time they were doing the Toys for Tots event. I said, hey, can we come over and make kind of a big splash? I'm like, yeah, what are you thinking? So we have a club trailer. It's about a 9-foot trailer that we'll bring to our car shows. You know, we fill it with our trophies and our 6-foot tables and all of our other stuff for the car shows. Well, we emptied that out and we would go shopping the night before the Toys for Tots car cruise. And over the years, one year we bought $6,000 worth of toys. The next year, if it was a little bit leaner, it was $3,000, maybe $2,000. But every year we like to go and make a big splash because locally in the car community, it's one thing to have a car show and you spend $20 and so forth. But where does that money go? I just don't want it to be pizza and beer at the next car club meeting. You want to be able to give that back to the local community. That's what our club is trying to do. Put it back into the community. Over the years, we've bought Christmas presents for military families that have one of their spouses that are deployed. It's about giving back to the community. And that's what the enjoyment of this car club is all about for me.
Very cool. Let's talk about the National Corvette Museum's Caravan, because you have been a leader for your region, but in 2019, in the most recent Caravan to the National Corvette Museum, you were the national chairman, and that was the 25th anniversary of the museum. Talk about that, because that had to be a gargantuan undertaking.
You heard the term herding cats?
Yep.
No, the Corvette Caravan is a special, special event in my heart. It was one of the first things that my wife and I did when we had the Corvette. I had mentioned we drove our 1998 Corvette on the 03 Caravan. I remember back in 09 was the first Caravan that I became involved with from a leader perspective. And I would say it was back in probably early 2008, the then president of our local Corvette club, his name was John Jack. Gentleman was contacted by the Corvette Museum and said, hey, would you and your club be interested in helping lead the New Jersey Caravan down to Kentucky? So John really didn't know what we were doing. He looked at me and said, Jeff, I'll do it if you help me. He was captain. I was co-captain for the then New Jersey Corvette Caravan. And most captains have about 4, maybe 5 years to plan for their event. We had roughly 12 months to put this thing together. So it was a little bit crazy back in 2009 when we did it, but we had an absolute blast doing it. And again, just the people that you meet in Bowling Green, across the region. And then in 2014, the museum had asked us to do it again. So we went ahead and we had obviously a lot more time to plan this one out and really, really had an amazing trip. What we did is we expanded it beyond New Jersey. It was the New York metro area, basically Eastern Pennsylvania, Delaware, Maryland. And we started at Corvettes at Carlisle in central Pennsylvania, which is the world's largest Corvette show. That was our meeting location. So we had cars joining us from all over the country and even out of Canada, because some of the Canadians would come down for Carlisle for the weekend. And then from Carlisle, we took a nice 2-3 day drive down to Bowling Green, Kentucky. Just had an unbelievable trip in 2014. While we were in Bowling Green, the museum kind of tapped me on the shoulder and said, "Hey, would you be interested in running the entire event for the entire country in 2019? Needless to say, I was quite humbled at the opportunity to do it and excited, but also extremely nervous and anxious when I first took on the role. What have I gotten myself into? But it was a great experience working with Bryce and Macy on the events team down at the museum and getting to know a lot of the folks at the Corvette Museum. People that I still consider friends to this day. It was a great opportunity to meet the other captains from around the region, around the country, I should say, not just the region of the East Coast, but got to be good friends with folks up from New England. Randy Flock did a great job up there. You've got guys out west that did a really good job. John Elegant and Ken Thomas, who did stuff out of the Pacific Northwest and the trips that they were working on. Hib Halberson from Southern California. He's now kind of given the reins over to Bill Harold, who was with Club Glove Luggage, and they're going to be running the trip from Southern California and put these guys in connection with each other. Coming from the Northeast or Mid-Atlantic region, it's not too far of a drive to Bowling Green. You can do it in 12 hours, but it's about the trip itself. But when you're coming from Seattle or Southern California, as you're coming east across the country, it's really cool to see how the different caravans connect in with each other and then become mega caravans. You might start out with 200 cars. You meet up with another group with another 200 cars. And by the time you get to Bowling Green, you could be close to 1,000 Corvettes staging and driving into the museum together. It is quite a sight.
Jeff, when is the next upcoming Corvette Caravan to the National Corvette Museum then?
Well, thanks, Steve. I'm glad you asked. The Corvette Museum hosts these National Corvette Caravans every 5 years to celebrate the milestone anniversary of the Corvette Museum. So the next scheduled caravan is in 2024, which will be celebrating the 30th anniversary of the National Corvette Museum. Plans are already being made for 2024 at this point. Here we are in late 2021, getting ready to enter into 2022. So if you are a owner of any Corvette, especially all these new C8 owners and all these first-time Corvette owners, I highly, highly recommend you checking out CorvetteCaravan.com and checking out your local region to get in touch with your local captain. If you don't have a captain set up in your area yet, please reach out to Frank, who is the national chairman for the 2024 caravan, the position that I held back in 2019. And quite frankly, if you want to send me an email about it as well, I can put you in touch with Frank for the 2024 caravan. It is an absolute bucket list, must-do type of event if you're a Corvette owner.
That's amazing. And another organization that is, I know, near and dear to your heart, as it is with me, from Corvettes at Carlisle, you're on the board of directors for the Chip Miller Foundation, aren't you?
That is correct. Yeah, the Chip Miller Amyloidosis Foundation. I am a proud board member of that for the past 2 years. I consider Lance Miller a close personal friend, and I'm also fortunate enough to have met Chip Miller while he was still with us before his untimely passing back in 2001. Lance and I have had a great relationship. Our daughters were born within 2 weeks of each other. Both our wives are roughly the same age, and Lance and I are close to the same age. So we have a lot of things in common outside of the Corvette world when it comes to our family. Lance asked me to be a part of this. I've always supported it before I was a board member. And now as a board member, I really do enjoy getting the information out and still continuing to support them financially, as well as whatever I can do as a board member with my time and talents.
Very cool. Well, buddy, let's take our final break. And when we come back in segment number three, we're going to talk about some of your social media here on Corvette Today.
American Hydrocarbon, your one-stop shop for custom interior, exterior, and engine bay items for your C4 through C8 Corvette. We can help you create a custom look for your Corvette with carbon fiber or 10 different color patterns and styles. We've served customers in over 28 countries all around the world. Whether it's a custom-made engine cover for your new C8 mid-engine Corvette or custom-made C4 interior upgrades, American Hydrocarbon can help you transform your Corvette into a best-in-class show car. Our products have been featured in Vet and Corvette magazines, so give us a call. 813-476-5638. That's 813-476-5638. And now we're proud to announce that we can produce and distribute officially licensed GM products with a C8 Corvette. That includes the front splitter, the side skirts, engine appearance panels, and engine fluid caps. See everything on our new updated website, AmericanHydrocarbon.com.
Hey, honey, are you awake?
I am now.
I can't sleep. Since turning 50, I keep dreaming of a red door and a blue door, somehow knowing there are only choices for retirement.
Okay.
Through the red door, we outlive our money. We have to rely on our kids. We're stuck on a fixed income. It's terrifying.
Yeah, that would suck.
But through the blue door, our money outlives us. We retire on our terms. Our kids stay our kids, not our caretakers. We make work optional.
Yes, that's much better. That's what I want too. But what do we do?
We call True Wealth and Company at 913-653-8783. They specialize in helping successful people make work optional. They're our fiduciary Blue Door personal wealth managers.
Hey, where are you going? It's 3 a.m.
I can't sleep. I'm going to check out True Wealth and Company online at retirewithtrue.com. That Blue Door is going to be our retirement.
913-653-8783. Visit us online at retirewithtrue.com. Investment advice offered through True Wealth and Company, LLC, a registered investment advisor in the state of Kansas.
You're listening to the Corvette Today podcast with Steve Garrett.
Hey, thank you very much for listening to Corvette Today, the podcast that talks about everything Corvette. I'm your host, Steve Garrett. With me this week is Jeff Duda, the host of Zipity's Garage on YouTube. As a matter of fact, in this third and final segment, we're going to talk about all of Jeff's social media. First of all, let's talk about Zipity's Garage. Jeff, talk about your YouTube channel, when you started, and how it got going.
Sure. Thanks for that. So yes, Zipity's Garage, not quite to the level of Jay Leno's garage just yet, but it is my humble beginnings at trying to do some entertainment on YouTube, and it's Zipity's Garage, and that is spelled Z-I-P-I-T-Y apostrophe S garage. And where that comes from is, you pronounce my last name, it's Duda. So you put that Zipity in front of the Duda, and you've got Zipity Duda Day.
My, oh my, what a wonderful day. Plenty of sunshine hitting my way. Zip-a-dee-doo-dah, zip-a-dee-ay.
That's kind of where the word Zipity came from. In fact, that's the vanity tag on my 2004 commemorative edition Z06 is Zipity. And people tend to think it's a zippy car. No, it's actually a play on my last name of Zipity Duda. My cousin out in Pittsburgh has a YouTube channel, and shout out to Pittsburgh Views. It's a play on his last name. He lives in Pittsburgh, but it's Pittsburgh Views. And he started a car YouTube channel. He'd been on me for 2 or 3 years. Start a channel. And I said, I've modified my Corvette. I've done everything I wanted to it. He goes, no, you do enough stuff in the car hobby that people will watch. So after some of the prodding from my cousin Brian, I said, all right, let's grab my iPhone and let's go shoot some video. And it started back in January of 2021. So we're coming up on about a year. One of the first videos I did is I went down to Atlantic City, which was then in the hands of Kerbeck, the number one Corvette dealership in the world, and is now owned by the Sioka family. But I took a GoPro camera down there and basically hit record and walked around and just showcased all the different colors, the different combinations, different wheels, carbon flash tops on all the different models of the Corvette. And I must have struck a chord, because there's videos that have gotten 20,000 views, 30,000 views on some of these dealer walk-arounds. And it's just me talking about the different color combinations and what the option packages are. And I guess around the country, most local Chevy dealers do not have cars that you can go look at. So somebody may not have been able to see a Rapid Blue in person, or an Accelerate Yellow, or what a Zeus Bronze car looked like. And I was able to capture that on my YouTube channel. So that's kind of how it got started. I don't want to be a how-to channel, because like I said, I have done a lot of the stuff to my car.
Sure.
And quite frankly, the way I learn how to do things is I watch YouTube. So I'm not, exactly. I'm hopefully not teaching anything incorrect. But the tagline I like to use is that I'm a car guy that brings you along to whatever event I go to.
Very nice.
I like to say it's dedicated to the fun and games of being an automotive enthusiast. So whatever that means to you, that's kind of what I try and bring to the people.
So is that the video that has the most views on it right now?
Correct. Yes. I also went down and did a walk around right before the announcement of the C8 Z06, and that has taken off as well. If you can figure out the YouTube algorithms, let me know, because I think there's many, many smarter people than me that have tried to do that and have yet to figure that out. So some videos take off where others may not do as well, but quite frankly, I'm not YouTube rich by any stretch of the imagination. I just go out and have some fun with it. For example, how I try to cross-pollinate some of these different things with the Chip Miller Amyloidosis Foundation. Lance and I went down to work a booth at Amelia Island this past spring. So I took the camera with me and took everybody to Amelia Island with me, and was able to really cover a lot of the stuff that was happening down at Amelia Island. Also, when we did the sweepstakes car for the Chip Miller Amyloidosis Foundation, we did the Cunningham car. This was the C8 that was built to pay tribute to the 1960 Corvette Cunningham car that won its class at Le Mans. And we did the public debut at Amelia Island, and I covered that on my channel. A lot of car show stuff. National Corvette Museum did an event here in Hershey, Pennsylvania with Doug Feehan and the folks from Mobile One and Michelin. Was able to cover a lot of that content. Tommy Milner was there. And if I'm headed to a Toys for Tots event, I'll cover that as well. So I just try and bring people along to whatever event that I'm heading to that weekend.
Very cool, Jeff. Very cool. How many subscribers do you have for the YouTube channel? The channel's been up for about a year. How many videos are on the channel?
Right now, I'm humbled to say I have just under 2,800 subscribers. So I got 2,785 subscribers, which blows me away. Again, I still can't believe folks watch the stuff, but they do. And I probably have close to 60 videos up on the site. At one point, I was trying to do a video a week. So you figure if there's 52 weeks in a year, I've got close to 60 up there. So I was hitting that cadence pretty good. One of my more popular videos was when Mike Furman down at Criswell sold his 5,000th Corvette delivery of his career. Mike asked me to come down and cover that. So that was a lot of fun. Again, stuff that the car, as well as the whole YouTube thing, that's a door that never would have opened for me. So that was a lot of fun going down to meet Mike Furman on a little bit more of a social call, as opposed to buying a car from him. And we've become great friends. So that was a lot of fun to do that video as well. There's a really cool video from my daily driver. I have a dash cam in my car. Back over the springtime, I was driving home from Ohio, crossing Pennsylvania, and I happened to drive through an F3 tornado.
Wow.
And caught it on the dash cam, pulled the memory card out of the dash cam and loaded that up onto the YouTube channel, almost like my modern day Twister. There were no flying cows past the windshield, but there was plenty of debris going by. So that's for sure.
Crazy stuff, buddy. Now let's talk about your other social media, because you're on Facebook and you're also on Instagram.
That is correct. I have my personal Facebook page, which is out there, but I also will post things on Zipity's Garage on Facebook as well as on Instagram. It's very easy to do that right from your cell phone. So please, if you follow me over on YouTube, please consider following me on the Instagram and the Facebook, because I can do that instantly from the cell phone as opposed to having to edit and upload videos to YouTube. Granted, I know you can do YouTube Live, but I've yet to dive into that. So when I'm out at an event, whether I'm covering a Corvette show, I did a Ferrari show a couple weeks ago, whatever it might be, I'll post that on the Instagram so that way you can see what's forthcoming onto the YouTube channel.
Now, when they go to Facebook and on Instagram, is it under Jeffrey Duda or is it under Zipity's Garage?
It is under Zipity's Garage is the best way to find it.
Sounds good. If someone wants to reach you personally, Jeff, how can they do that?
Sure. It's quite easy. I've got two email addresses for you. And the first one would be just zipitysgarage@gmail.com. If you're interested in the 2024 Corvette Caravan, I've got a separate email set up for that. And that is 2024AtlanticCaravan@gmail.com. So I'll respond to both of those emails. So if it's Zipity's Garage related, Corvette related, please connect with me through the Zipity's Garage address. Or if you're interested on anything related to the Caravan, reach out to me through the Caravan email address.
Very cool, buddy. Thank you so much for taking the time to be on Corvette today, Jeff. This has been a lot of fun, and all the best of luck to you in the future with all your social media outlets.
Thank you very much, Steve. I'm humbled to be a part of it. And thank you, thank you, thank you for including me.
Thanks for listening to Corvette Today. And please be sure to tell your family, friends, and other Corvette enthusiasts about the Corvette Today podcast. And also thanks to our flagship sponsors, American Hydrocarbon at AmericanHydrocarbon.com, True Wealth & Company at RetireWithTrue.com. Also, Aerolari Wheels, get $100 off your purchase with the promo code CT100 at Aerolari.com. Also, Nova Stretch Bras. Use the code CORVETTETODAY15 and get 15% off your total purchase at NovaStretch.com.
You've been listening to Corvette Today with Steve Garrett. If you'd like to contact Steve with any thoughts on the podcast or ideas for guests on Corvette Today, you can email him at SteveGarrettDJ@gmail.com. That's SteveGarrettDJ@gmail.com. Garrett has two R's and two T's. Or connect with Steve on social media on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram using @SteveGarrettDJ. Thanks again for listening to Corvette Today.